Hi everyone, today again we are here with our chapter trigonometric identities. Yesterday we have discussed about our trigonometric identities there, in which we discussed yesterday our trigonometric identities. Now today we are again with some selected examples with our trigonometric identities there. Just yesterday what we get? We get our three identities. What is our first one is what? It's sine square a plus cos square a equal to 1. Then our second identity is what? It's a 1 plus 10 square a sec square a. Then we get our third identity is what? Our third identity is what? 1 plus cot square a equal to cosec square a. Now move to this is our first identity, sine square a plus cos square a. How we can get? Yesterday we have discussed that using Pythagoras theorem, a b square plus b c square equal to a c square. Then after that we get the values there. Now look, it is our first identity. Then we can also interest in the identity to get our others for others values of a. If we have sine square a plus cos square equal to 1, then to solve it, when we get our cos square in the form of, we get here for cos square is what? It's a 1 minus sine square a. Also from this we can also get the value of sine square a in the form of cos. It's what? It's our 1 minus cos square a. Then we get two forms with our first identity, sine square a plus cos square a equal to 1. Then we get cos square a equal to 1 minus sine square a. Also we get sine square a equal to 1 minus cos square a. Similarly, from second identity, what we have? We have 1 plus 10 square equal to sec square a. Then from here we get 10 square a is what? It's our is equal to sec square a minus 1. Also what we get? We get here sec square a minus 10 square a. Sec square a minus 10 square equal to 1. Then from here, when we have 1 plus cot square a equal to cosec square a, then what we get here? We also, from this identity, what we get here? Cot square a is equal to cosec square a minus 1. And also what we get? Cosec square a minus cot square a equal to 1. Then from this three identity we can also use this one as identity there. Cos square a equal to 1 minus sine square a. Sine square a equal to 1 minus cos square a. Then 10 square a equal to sec square a minus 1, and sec square a minus 10 square equal to 1. Also, we have cot square equal to cosec square a minus 1, and cosec square a minus cot square a equal to 1 there. Now, from these identities, we are going to discuss some problem there. This also based on our NCERT problem there. There is some problem like that. Now, we have to be express sin a, sec a and tan a in the terms of cot a. We have to express our sin, sec and tan a in the terms of cot a. How can we do it? We are start with our basic. Now we are going to start with this to represent sin a in the forms of cot a. But we know that what is sin a? How can we start with sin a? Sin a is what? It's a 1 upon cosec a. There is not a relationship between sin to cot directly. What we have? We have sin. There is relationship sin to cosec directly. And sin a equal to 1 by cos a k, we are start with here. Then now what we can try it? We can also try it. We can write down this also. Taking a square and taking a square root. Then what do we have? We have 1 upon under root cos a k square. Now our sin a in the can be represent. Now we have there is a relationship between cos a k and cot. what we see here. One plus cot square a equal to cosec square a. Then cosec square a is what? It's equal to one plus cot square a. We get cosec square a here. Then now it's a under root one plus cot square a by using identity sin a. What is identity? Cosec square a equal to one plus cot square a. Then we get sin a in the form of, in the terms of cot a. This is our first requirement. But we have to find out the value of sec and tan a also in the terms of cot a. Now we are moved to sec a. How can we represent our sec? There is again directly not relationship between sec and cot. Then our sec is related with cos a. Now how can we convert it in the cot? What we do? We are going to be dividing numerator and denominator by sin a, because we have to convert this formula into terms of cot. Cot is what? Cot is what? Cos upon sin. That's why I'm using going to be divided by denominator by sin there. Now what we have here, 1 upon sin a is what? It's a cosec a, and cos a upon sin a is what? It's our cot a. We have cosec a upon cot a. Now what is the value of cosec a? From we have the identity cosec square a equal to 1 plus cot square a. Then cosec a is what? Then our cosec a we converted in the square root of 1 plus cot square a and divided by cot a. Now we have solving our sec a in the form of, in the terms of cot. Now this is last. We have to also tan represent in the terms of cot a. This is easy one. Was just going to using our reciprocal formula. Tan a is what? It's a 1 upon cot a. This is our requirement. We have solving our sin a, sec a and tan a in the terms of cot a. Now we are moved to another problem there. Evaluate sin square 35 plus sin square 55 there. Now we have to find the value of lookup. After watching this again, you have in your mind that I am telling you again and again, when we have not any specified angle there, 0, 30, 45, 60, 90, then we are using there, then what is using there? We are using our complementary angles formula there, and we are using where our angle is greater than 45 degree. Then first of all, write down sin square 35 as it is. Sin square 35, this angle is greater than 45 degree, then we are going to here use our complementary formula. 55 can be written as 90 minus 35. 90 minus 35, we get 55. Now we have read that our sin 90 minus theta is what? It's a cos theta. Then this is converted to, it's a sin square 35. Now what is, since sin 90 minus cos theta, then our sin square is converted to cos square theta. Theta is what? Our 35 degree. Now look, it's a sin square 35 plus cos square 35. Now what? It's a form of sin square theta plus cos square theta. By identity, we have its values 1. Both theta are equal there, then its value is what? 1. Since what we have? Sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. Our angles are there, then by first identity, its value is what? We're getting 1 here. Now, again, I am taking a problem using our is topic of this chapter. We're having using here a complementary formula as well as here we're using our identity based problem there, because we have to be revise complementary angles and then as well as your identity formula used to there. That's why we have taken the such problems. Here which we are going to use our complementary angles as well as our identity there. Now we are start with again sin square 20 plus sin square 70 divided by sin theta into cos 90 minus theta plus cos theta into sin 90 minus theta. Then look here again, it's not a specified angle formula, then we have to use our complementary angles there. It's 20 less than 45 degree is 70, then we are going to convert our 70 degree. We start with write down sine square 20 as it is. This can be written as sine square. How we get 70? 90 minus 20, we get 70 here. And then it's a sine theta, write down it's sine theta. By complementary formula, cos of 90 minus theta is equal to sine theta. Write down cos theta as it is. And it's a sine 90 minus theta. By complementary formula, its value is what? It's a cos theta. Now what we have? It's a sine square 20. Again by complementary, sine 90 minus theta is what? Cos. Then it's our cos square 20. Then we have sine into sine, we get sine square theta. Cos into cos, we get cos square theta. Now this is sine square 20 plus cos square 20. By identity, the value of this is what? 1. And also sine square theta plus cos square theta, this by using, since we having identity, sine square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. This is 1. Again here our theta is same, 20 and 20, then this value, its value is also 1. Then 1 by 1, what do we get? We get 1 here. Then we getting, we are evaluating the values of this expression is as 1 there. Now move to with our next example. We have to find some values there. Now, look. We have to find the value of 9 sec square a minus 9 tan square a. It's a very simple problem there. Nothing to do, very difficult here. Just if you have remembered your identity, if you are aware of your identity there, you can get easily, you are going to get easily verify it. Just here is 9, here is 9. What do you do? We start with 9 sec square a minus 9 tan square a. What we are going to take 9 common there, then what we have, it's a sec square a minus 10 square a. Now what is identity we have? We have identity 1 plus 10 square a equal to sec square a. From this, what we have? We have sec square a minus 10 square a equal to 1. Then here we get 1, then 9 into 1, what we have? We have get here 9 here. Move to be another problem there. We have to be simplify here. We have to be simplify sine cube theta plus cos cube theta divided by sine theta plus cos theta, then plus sine theta into cos theta. Again, we have to solve it by using identity there. Look, first of all, I don't, it's a sine cube theta plus cos cube theta, sine theta plus cos theta, then plus sine theta into cos theta. Here is what, it's a type of a cube plus b cube. It's a cube plus b cube. What is the expression for a cube plus b cube? We have a plus b, a square plus b square minus ab. Then we are going to using our algebraic identity there to break sine cube plus cos cube in that given form. Then from this algebraic identity, what we have? A plus b, then we have sine theta plus cos theta, then a square plus b square minus ab. Our a is what? It's a sine square theta. B is what? Cos square theta. Then minus a into b means minus sine theta into cos theta divided by sine theta plus cos theta, then plus sine theta into cos theta. Then look, this is sine theta plus cos theta. Here we have into there, then we can cancel out this expression here. Now what we have? We have sine square theta plus cos square theta माइनस साइन थीटा इंटू कॉस थीटा, साइन स्क्वायर प्लस कॉस स्क्वायर माइनस साइन थीटा इंटू कॉस थीटा, देन वी हैव प्लस साइन थीटा इंटू कॉस थीटा. व्हाट वी डू, दिस इज माइनस दिस इज प्लस, दिस वन इज कैंसिल आउट, देन व्हाट वी हैव साइन स्क्वायर थीटा प्लस कॉस स्क्वायर थीटा, वी गेट हियर बाय आइडेंटिटी. व्हाट वी हैव आइडेंटिटी, वी हैव साइन स्क्वायर थीटा प्लस कॉस स्क्वायर थीटा इज वन देयर. नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू अगेन रिवाइज दिस प्रॉब्लम, इट्स अ वन ऑफ द इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉब्लम देयर. व्हाट वी हैव सिंप्लीफाई साइन क्यूब प्लस कॉस क्यूब थीटा डिवाइडेड बाय साइन थीटा प्लस कॉस थीटा प्लस साइन थीटा इंटू कॉस थीटा देयर. देन व्हाट वी डू, वी आर यूजिंग एलजेब्रिक आइडेंटिटी देयर, write down expression, then after that we have using our algebraic identity there. What we do, we are doing a cube plus b cube. What is a cube plus b cube expression there, we can write down a plus b into a square plus b square minus ab. By using this algebraic identity, we are going to be break our sine cube plus cos cube in the form of a plus b. What is our a, sine theta, b is what, cos theta, then a square plus b square minus a into b divided by sin theta plus cos theta, then write down this identity here. Now what we do, then after that we are going to be cancel out this sin theta plus cos theta by this, then we have sin square theta plus cos square theta minus sin theta into cos theta, then this is our with minus sign, this is our plus sign, then our sin square theta plus cos square theta is what, it's a 1 by using identity. Now we are moved to with another problem there. Now we have to prove that sin 2 power 4 minus cos 2 power 4 theta is equal to sin square theta minus cos square theta. We are going to start with write down sin 2 power 4 theta minus cos 2 power 4 theta. Now we are taking since we have to prove that, then we start with our left hand side. In trigonometry we can proving parts, we can prove it by using left to right side, we can also prove it by using right to left or left to right, we can easily, but try to that taking the that part which is larger than here, sin 2 power 4 minus cos 2 power, here is power 4 there, then in our right hand side is the sin square minus cos square, then it's easy to get down with sin 2 power 4 minus cos 2 power 2 sin square minus cos square. So and it's a little bit difficult to get the sin square minus cos square to the sin 2 power 4 minus cos 2 power 4, because we have to be go from lower to higher, then we have to be think what we have to need there. But this to going left to right is easy there. Then we start with our left hand side. What do we have? We have sin 2 power 4 theta minus cos 2 power 4 theta. Then we can write down it. We can write down it's, but it's a sin square theta whole square. And it's a cos square theta whole square. Now it's a form of a square minus b square. It can be expressed in a plus b and a minus b. Then now by using this identity, we have it's a sin square theta plus cos square theta, and then sin square theta minus cos square theta. We have already read this is identity. This is equal to 1. And we get 1 here. Now 1 into this, then we get our sin square theta minus cos square theta. This is our required right hand side. What we have to prove that? We have to prove that sin 2 power 4 theta minus cos 2 power 4 theta equal to sin square theta minus cos square theta. Then we can, if you want to try to prove that the same problem from right to left, then we can also do that. From right hand side, we have taken right hand side. What is our right hand side? Sin square theta minus cos square theta. Now what we do? We can write down it sin square theta minus cos square theta into 1. There is no change in to multiply this identity with 1. Now what we do, we are going to do sin square theta minus cos square theta in the 1 we are going to put what we have going to take this sin square theta plus cos square theta is what 1 there. Now it's a minus b and a plus b, then it's a square minus b square, and after that it's a sin square whole square, then sin 2 power 4 theta cos square to whole square, then we get here our left hand side. But we have to be think here, we have to multiply this identity with 1. And what we in trigonometry we can proving part, we can prove from left to right. Also we can prove that from right, it's a right to left there. Now we are moving to with right on with next problem there. What is our next problem? We have to be prove that, just take away the identity there, cosec theta minus cot theta whole square is equal to 1 minus cos theta to the 1 plus cos theta. Now we have to prove that cosec theta minus cot theta whole square equal to 1 minus cos theta is to 1 plus cos theta. Again I am going to tell that we have a start with right to left or left to right. Just suppose we start with right, we're taking our right hand side, 1 minus cos theta to 1 plus cos theta. We're taking our right hand side, then after that we are moved to our left hand side. We need here cosec theta minus cot theta. Now look, we need here our cosec, and there is also being a square there, then we have to be use convert this our right hand side to using to convert in this some square form. Then we are going to be rationalize our denominator there. We are going to rationalize our denominator. We are going to multiply with 1 minus cot theta minus cos theta. We are going to rationalize our denominator. Now what we have? Here we have 1 minus cos theta. This is a minus b into a minus b. Then we have a minus b whole square. Now it is what? It's a plus b into a minus b. Then what? We have 1 square minus cos theta square. Now what we have? We have 1 minus cos theta whole square, and here what we get? We get 1 minus cos square theta. Now what? Write down 1 minus cos theta whole square, then this is 1 minus cos square is what? It's a sin square theta. Now look, being this is a square, this is also a square, we can write down 1 minus cos theta v square. We can also write this sin theta whole square. Now we can write down this as 1 minus cos theta upon sin theta taking whole square by using our algebraic expression there in class 9, that if a to power m b to power m can be written as a by b to power m. Then now what we do? We are going to divide by now 1 upon sin theta minus cos theta upon sin theta whole square. What is our 1 by sin? 1 by sin is what? It's our cosec theta. And cos upon sin is what? It's our cot theta. What we have to prove? We have to prove that cosec theta minus cot theta whole square. And this is our left hand side. This is our left hand side. Again we can prove same question. We are starting with right to left there, and again we going to start with left to right. Just suppose we have to want to prove that with from here to here, we want to prove our cosec theta minus cot square theta is 1 minus cos upon 1 plus cos there. And what we have to do now, again we are going to we start with our left hand side. What do we have? We have cosec theta minus cot theta whole square. Now we take to prove same question by using our left hand side. Now how can we write? Our cosec is what? It's a 1 upon sin theta. What is our cos? Our cos can be cot can be represented as cos to the sin cos theta upon sine theta whole square. Now take the LCM there. Now it's a 1 minus cos theta is 2 sine theta whole square. Now what we are going to do? We can write it's 1 minus cos theta whole square, and this sine theta can be written as sine square theta. Now we know the identity. The value of sine square theta is written as 1 minus cos square theta. And here we are going to put that 1 minus cos theta whole square. Using identities as sine square theta can be written as 1 minus cos square theta. Then it's a 1 minus cos square theta. Now it's a 1 minus cos theta whole square. And this is a square minus b square type. Then what we have? We have 1 minus cos theta a minus b into a plus b 1 plus cos theta. And this is 1 minus cos theta. Is cancel out this square. Then what we have? We have 1 minus cos theta to the 1 plus cos theta. Now we start with left hand side and proving our, what is our right hand side to prove? 1 minus cos theta is 2. 1 minus cos theta is 2. 1 plus cos theta. This is our right hand side. What we saw here, in trigonometry we can proving part can be do with right to left. We can prove by right to left, and also we can prove our same problem by using identity of to our right to left or left to right there. It depends on you, which is what's in your mind, click there, go to prove left to right, or you are going to prove. But also there is one of the part, you are going getting some problem there, in which there is not easy to move with left to right there, or left to right directly there. Then some problem, what we do, we are given some problems, we have to just do, we are solving our left hand side and moving some simplifying there. Then we are going to take our right hand side and then simplifying there some values there. Then after that, getting same values, we are going to that since the both are proceed to same value, then our left and right are equal there. Just one of the example there. Sometimes we happen, look, with the given problem, the surface, we have a problem like that. We have to prove that cosec A minus sin A and sec A minus cos A. We have to prove that 1 upon tan A plus cot A. Here something difficult to go to our left hand side to right hand side. In such type of problem, we start with left hand side. Now we take our left hand side. It's a cosec A minus sin A. Then it can be written as cosec is what? It's our 1 upon sin A. Then sin A. Here our second part. I forgot that. Sec A minus cosec A. Then our sec A is what? It's a 1 upon cos A minus cos A. Now taking the LCM, 1 minus sin square A is 2 sin A. Then 1 minus cos square A is 2 cos A. Then 1 minus sin square A is what? It's a cos square A is 2 sin A. Then 1 minus cos square A is what? It's a sin square A is 2 cos A. Now here cancel, this cancel out. Then what we have? We have, look, we have here one cos, then cos A, here we one sin, then sin A. Now we have cos A into sin A. Now it's a difficult to change cos A into sin A to the 1 upon tan A plus cot A. And we are leave it our left hand side to here. With we are going to take our right hand side. What is our right hand side? 1 upon tan A plus cot A. We are going to our solve right hand side. Our tan is what? It's a sin A to cos A. Plus cot is what? It's a cos A to sin A. And taking the LCM, we get sin square A. Here we get cos square A. And our denominator is what? It's a cos A into sin A. Now shifting, then we get cos a into sin a. To the denominator we have sin square a plus cos square a. By identity this value is 1, then we have cos a into sin a. Now look, our left hand side tends to cos into sin a, our right hand side also tends to cos into sin a, and this both are implement to same values there. Then in the case our left hand side equal to right hand side from 1 and 2. Some problems we also solve by this method. Tends to solve left hand side to some values there, then also solve right hand side to get same value here. Then so that since our 1 and by equation 1 and 2, our left hand side and right hand side both are equal there.